继美国通过《香港人权与民主法案》和《维吾尔人权政策法案》后，两名加拿大参议员近日也提出动议，呼吁加拿大政府落实马格尼茨基法案，制裁侵犯人权的香港和中共官员。
加拿大参议院节日休会前，参议员 Leo Hosokos 和吴兰海提出动议，要求加拿大政府使用马格尼茨基法制裁侵犯人权的香港和中共官员。
The PRC is a dictatorship possessing a complete disregard for fundamental freedom, democracy, and certainly rule of law. They are amongst the world's worst violators of human rights. When it comes to minority Muslims, it is also brutally cracking down on pro-democracy dissidents in Hong Kong.
Will the heinous crime stop if we only resort to dialogue and international diplomacy?I very highly doubt it. The detention, the persecution, and forced assimilation of the minority Muslim and other ethno-religious minority in Xinjiang has been going on over for years now. And it doesn't look like it will stop anytime soon. The harvesting of organs and the persecution of the people that practice Falun Gong.Has been going on for years now, and it doesn't seem it will stop.
参议员 Hosokos 接受采访时表示，中共不仅践踏中国人的人权，还为报复华为高管孟晚舟被捕，非法关押两名加拿大人整整一年。加国政府早该拿出行动，捍卫普世价值。
We see it in the case of Mr. Kovrig and Mr. Spavor. It's nothing more than retaliation against Canada on a political basis, and it's completely unacceptable. And for far too long, Canada has turned a blind eye in these atrocities.
目前，美国、加拿大等六国都通过了全球马格尼茨基法，允许对世界各地的侵犯人权者实施冻结资产和履行禁令等制裁。欧盟、澳洲正在审议相关立法。
As we did vis-à-vis Russians, Venezuela, Myanmar, and why not China?
该动议将在明年二月参议院复会后继续讨论。新唐记者朱峰、周立敏，加拿大报道。